Why TLT just dropped under $99. Why you will want to buy a US Treasury bond now to prepare for what's to come. We know the fundamental reason why TLT is falling. It's because of the bond market and the Federal Reserve's inflation expectations, aka the oil price. The reduction of production quotas by OPEC Plus members by 2 million barrels per day will not lead to an increase in the oil price for long term. When you have the highest dollar in a decade, the highest interest rates in a decade, and the highest energy price in years, it's game over for consumers and the economy. That's a guarantee global recession, and that's one of the reasons why oil prices will fall in 2023. I have two more reasons why deflation is coming, plus a bonus one at the end. These will give you enough conviction for you to buy and own your TLT at today's attractive prices, under $100 a share. Do I still think US Treasury bonds, TLT, are a safe haven? Now at under $100 per share. I will explain it all right after this. And of course, smash the like button. If you want to be my good boy, apply to write your first book with me. Welcome back to the Audacious Money Witch channel, where we talk about macroeconomy, stocks, bonds, and commodity markets. If you like any of these markets, please consider subscribing. It's totally free. And of course, tap the like button if you enjoy what you see in today's video. If you like any of these topics, you are intelligent. That's why you're here. You know what to do and push my button because I can't push it from this side. This video is brought to you by my Patreon. If you are a sweet boy, go to patreon.com/magicalgoddesscheryl to support all my work. If you want to be my good boy, apply to write your first book with me, author of best-selling books, Goddess Cheryl. My good boys always obey, and they always get rewarded handsomely. Have you been a good boy? You will get the encouragement you need to be on your author journey. There have been a lot of Lehman comparisons made in recent weeks and months with regards to fallout from the energy crisis. Wall Street Bank CEO Jamie Dimon said, "Ever since the war started, it's predictable that oil price would go up." By the way, for the climate folks here, high energy prices have made the climate worse because people had this false assumption that higher oil and gas prices reduce consumption, reduce carbon dioxide. Nope. Developing nations like India, China, Philippines, Vietnam are turning back on coal plants. Same as the European nations called Germany, Netherlands going back on coal burning too. In Jamie Dimon's view, America should have been pumping oil and gas to avert war-level energy crisis. In the run-up to elections, the White House can use many tools to lower U.S. fuel prices. One such tool is the introduction of export restrictions on gasoline and diesel, while increase their production in North America. At the same time, US and EU officials are starting to negotiate more closely with Iran and Venezuela to lift sanctions to increase oil supplies. As a result, I believe WTI oil prices are near their peaks. From the beginning of 2023, we may see a double-digit drop in the price of oil. This could also mean 10-year yield would peak at 4% and could head down soon. This will make TLT price go back up from under $100 low. Another deflation pressure is that inventory accumulation seems to be overwhelming manufacturers and retailers. This is coming from the open letter of the Fed by Catherine Wood. After grappling with supply chain constraints for more than a year, even world-class companies seem to have overruled their automated enterprise resource planning systems and overordered merchandise. In face of single-digit sales growth during the most recent quarter, inventories at Walmart and Target increased 25% and 36%, respectively. Nike's most recent quarterly results suggest, despite sales growth of only 3.6%, Nike's inventories increased 44.2% globally in North America and on ships in transit. Its inventories increased 65% and 85%, respectively, so wow. There are a lot of Nike shoes sitting just on ships. All these are deflation pressures caused by the unprecedented 13x increase in interest rates increase by the Fed. Highest US dollar in a decade caused by the Fed, and highest energy prices in years caused by nuclear war level energy crisis. All these have shocked not just the US but the whole world and raised the risk of a deflationary bust. So why did the Treasury bonds crash on Monday? Is it because it lost its safe haven status? Nope. It's only because of BOE's new support plan fails as UK gilt yields explode higher. Despite the BOE promises to do almost whatever it takes, long-dated gilt prices are collapsing today. 30-year gilt yields are up a stunning 34 BPS now, soaring towards crisis highs. The pain in the UK is spreading to US yields, indicated that the bank intends to charge forward on interest rate hikes, suggesting that this is the only way to tame the ongoing inflation crisis. However difficult the consequences might be for the economy, the MPC must stay the course and set monetary policy to return inflation to achieve the 2% target sustainably in the medium term, consistent with the remit given to us. Just 2 days after that statement, BOE on Monday announced further measures to ensure financial stability in the UK, building on its intervention in a long-dated bond market. Specifically, the BOE said it will double the size of its auctions to purchase long-dated government bonds to $10 billion a day until October 14th, when the BOE plans to close that program as previously announced. Launch a temporary expanded collateral repo facility, or TECRF, that will run beyond the end of this week until November 10th. Its purpose is to enable banks to ease pressures in LDI funds through liquidity insurance operations. Temporary expansion of collateral it accepts under its existing sterling monetary framework to include corporate bonds. Additionally, regular repo related operations also remain available to help. So far, investors haven't taken up as much of the support as the BOE has offered. In the 8 auctions to date, the BOE bought just $4.6 billion of bonds, about 12% of the $40 billion capacity of the program. However, analysts have warned that the intervention fails to adequately address the underlying issue. The suspicion is that risk reduction by pension funds has been too limited so far. The question is, do they have enough cash to meet new collateral requirements if the gilt market sells off again, if the gilt purchases by the Bank of England end this week? I think the fear is that The answer is no, and that it will trigger the same snowball effect that we had 2 weeks ago, that the new measures would likely assuage market concerns in the short term, but a number of major problems remain going into 2023, the first of which is that the Bank of England will need to raise interest rates further. First, the BOE did not get anywhere close to buying the maximum amounts in the previous operations anyway, and thus increasing the maximum potential purchases would not necessarily change the fate of the market if actual purchases remain low. Secondly, as regards the repo operations, the question is whether there has been a significant liquidity demand from banks in the first place. And furthermore, it appears that the repos collateralized with corporate bonds appear quite expensive, with rather large haircuts applied, and thus it remains debatable whether they will be used much in the first place. The BOE has a problem, however, as this desperate move has prompted more selling in the 30-year gilt yields up 22 basis points today. It is extraordinary. Market interventions of this type by the central bank are not normal. Not normal indeed. As soon as oil price drops, which it always will, when the Fed admits recession is here, probably close to the election, TLT will go up as the stocks will start to panic crash. By then, the VIX will be sky high, probably above 100, because TLT always goes up after the Fed pivots, dropping the interest rate back to 0%. To deal with a deflationary crisis crash. Yes, TLT is still the safe haven asset. And now I'm going to show you my client Tina Kadisha's Freedom Book, 7 Steps to Thrive in Life and Business. Such a good business book, this one. And my client Teddy Easy's Wicked Pussy Perfume. It's such an incredible erotic novel, this one. So it is an erotic novel. So amazing. And my book, it is a bestseller, and it's called I Am. So success is in the mind of the believer. And my book, You Hold the Magical Key to Your Success, another incredible book. So these books all help with anxiety, depression, and stress. Order your copy today. So a big shout out for Genuine Toya. She is on YouTube, so please check out her music, and a big shout out to her. Yay, Toya. So please like my video and comment in the sections below on what you think. And I thank you for being a fan and for supporting me. Bye.